Hi guys, this is just a quick tip for those who are wanting to create their own height reference in Maya. Now the height reference, you've seen me use it a number of times. I just basically go to my little trusty marking menu right here and go create height reference. And what it does is it creates a curve that helps me gauge the height of a character. Now you don't have to use a curve as simple as this, you can make it as complicated as you want, but I'm going to show you how to create this really, really simple one very quickly, okay? So what you want to do is go down to the bottom right to your script editor. Just open this up. Let's clear this out. And what I want to do is go to my front view. So just tap my space and then go to my front view, tap the space right here. Now each square is 1 centimeter. Now the average human height is 160 centimeters. So for me to measure this, the simplest way to do that is just to go ahead and create a polygon cube or polygon plane like so. Now this is 2 units, okay, which is 2 centimeters high. Should probably turn this to 1 subdivision. So 2 centimeters high. I'm going to hold D, hold X, middle mouse button, and just lock that origin, sorry, the anchor point on the bottom of the origin right there. Let's scale the Y axis up to 160 centimeters. So because it's 2 centimeters small, I'm going to just put 80. All right, and the top right here, that's 160 centimeters, all right? Next thing we wanna do, so leave our script editor right here, is go to create, go to my EB curve tool, go to my options box, make sure it is on linear because I don't want this to be a curve, I want it to be nice and straight, and I'm just going to roughly hold X and drag it onto the bottom of my scene right there, click up the top, create the top part, like so, do it to the horizontal side and do it to the bottom once again. Oops, not straight on the bottom, so just make sure I get it straight. It can be a little bit tricky to see, so if you're not certain, go ahead and move that around. There we go, perfect. All right, and don't do anything, let's just clear this. Now we still have this selected, so press enter, and that's your code. Okay, so that's the code that you want to use to create your height reference. Like I said, you don't have to, it doesn't have to be as simple as this. You can make it super complicated with a variety of different things, but that's essentially how you create the code for your height reference map right there. Ooh, dear, we've got a bit strange right there. Now, if you want to rename this, you can go ahead and add a new flag. So, dash N and name this height reference. Hopefully that'll work. I'm just trying to remember if this is the correct way of doing it. So we go, there we go. All right. So if you put dash N and call it height reference, it will automatically rename that curve to height reference. Okay. So that's how you can use, that's how you create the height reference so that you can use it as just a general guide for your character modeling. Okay. Now, if you want to save this into your scene, go ahead and go to your custom tab right here, or you can create your new one, which is somewhere under the shelf editor. I'm just going to leave it in the custom tab. Just select the code under the reference, hold middle mouse and drag it onto the shelf. Okay, so from now on you can just click the shelf and go, oh yeah, I've got my height reference right there. It's fantastic, it's all automated. The other thing you can also do is go ahead and put it in your marking menu, which is what you've been seeing me use. This is a marking menu that I've created for myself. So let's go to Window, Settings, Preferences, go to Marking Menu Editor, let's just load menus. Just copy that code right there. Okay, I'm going to close that off. And I usually put it under my auto scripts, but you can put it anywhere for yourself. I'm just going to delete that because I had another one as an example. What you do is, just right click, go Edit Menu Item, copy that command or that code into the commands box right there, and label this Height Reference. All right, save and close. You can also click here to test, so you can see your height, that's the height reference right there. So I'm gonna save it, I'm gonna close it, I'm going to apply settings. All right, and what I'm gonna get is if I go to my marking menu, you can see, oh, like magic, I've got my marking menu height reference. All right, so that's how I've been using my marking menu height references. That's actually a little bit shorter. That's the original one that I've been using because I've been using it based on UDK. But again, that's generally how you do it.